Hey everybody, welcome to this tutorial on Audacity, a free and open source multi-track audio editor available for Windows, macOS, and Linux, offering an array of tools for recording, editing, and refining your sound. Download Audacity from the links in the video description. When you launch Audacity, you open its main interface with several options at the top and a timeline in seconds. Head to Edit, Preferences, Interface to change the theme colors if you need. Switch to Audio Settings to adjust the project options, such as the correct output speakers and microphone inputs, the number of recording channels, the sample rate, and format to use. At the bottom, you can also set the playback tempo, defining the number of beats per minute or BPM when moving from seconds to bars, and the time signature to fix the number of beats per bar. To record with your microphone, create a new audio track by right-clicking on any vacant space and click anywhere to fix where you want to place the new recording. At this point, click on the Record button and check the microphone output from the first volume meter above. If this remains inactive, make sure to check the source selected from Audio Setup, Recording Device. Use the Stop button or the Spacebar key to stop recording, shown as a clip with its audio waveforms collected inside the audio track. To check it, click on the timeline for a quick playback and drag the track borders to get a more detailed waveform. You can also capture the system audio of your computer. In Windows, head to Audio Setup, Host, and select Windows Wasapi. On Recording Device, select the system output, ensuring this has the same channels and sample rate set for the Audacity project. When you hit record, Audacity will be ready to capture sound from the selected source. For the best results, make sure to record with a vacant Audacity project. Use the Stop button to finish, and switch the host back to MME. You can import FLAC, MP3, or WAV files by dragging and dropping these on the timeline. You can also import M4A, WMA, or MP4 if you install the FFmpeg plugin, as you can check from the dedicated link in the video description. You can also import MIDI on Audacity. However, support on MIDI files remains limited, as Audacity is mainly an audio editor. Hold the Control key and use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out around the cursor. To play the timeline content, use the player above or the spacebar key. Press P to pause and resume. The playback follows the green marker in time, with its position displayed at the bottom in seconds. Right-click on such display or on the timeline to switch the format from seconds to bars. You can also play back a specific section in loop. Click and drag on the timeline to define the region and toggle the loop on or off with the Enable Looping button. Now, let's see how to edit your clips with the Selection tool. Click on any clip name to select it entirely and drag it and move it in time, within the same track or in another one. At the bottom, enable or disable the snapping options. Undo any action with Control or Command and Z. To trim any clip, click and drag inward from the top edge. You can also split it by clicking on the track and pressing Control or Command and I. You can cut, copy, or paste the selected clip with Control or Command and X, C, or V, and delete it quickly with Backspace. You can also select part of any clip by clicking and dragging on it to cut or remove only such specific region. Switch to the Envelope tool to control the volume of any clip in time. This places control points on the clip waveform that save the amplitude gain at that instant. A single point sets a constant volume gain, while a pair of points creates a smooth fade from one level to another. This is useful to smoothly increase volume, or fade in, or decrease it, or fade out. If you need to regulate the dynamic, right-click on the left levels and choose Zoom In or Out. Enable the Draw tool to remove clicks and spikes. Just zoom in enough on any clip to show its individual samples, and click and drag to reshape the waveform. You can hold Control down to move one sample at a time, and the Alt key to smooth the waveform as you need. Each track comes with its own set of options on the left side. Use the arrow above to collapse or expand each track. The mute button to silence the entire track content, and the solo button to play the track solo. You can also use the first slider to adjust the track volume, and the second one to balance the panning between the left and the right stereo channel. You can also right-click on the track name and go to Spectrogram to check the power spectrum over time across all frequencies. Now, let's see how to apply audio effects to entire tracks or single clips. To add effects on an entire track, click on the Effects button on the left, then to Add Effect. These effects are applied in real time and can be edited while in playback. You can head to Get More Effects to download and install more plugins, relaunching Audacity to see them in the list. Check our video description to get useful links on how to download and install plugins in Audacity. The effects you add create a chain where effects are applied in order. Click on any effect name to open its panel, and use the I/O button to turn it off or on. You can also drag any effect up or down to change the order. To remove any effect, click on the right arrow and choose No Effect. You can also add Nyquist effects that can be applied to any selected clip instead of an entire track. From the Effects tab, you get the complete list. For example, use Change Speed to change the speed rate of the clip. Noise Reduction to remove noise from any recorded speech. Compressor to reduce loudness from peaks. And EQ to apply custom audio filters. All these effects are applied permanently unless you undo with Control or Command and Z. To save your entire Audacity project, go to File, Save Project As, and save in a .aup3 file format. To export your project as an audio file, go to File, Export Audio, selecting between exporting online or offline in your computer. And finally, choose the format between MP3, WAV, and many others. You can also select any part of the clip to export alone by choosing the current selection option. Thank you so much, everyone, for watching this Audacity tutorial. To deepen your knowledge of audio editing and discover more free software tools, be sure to visit our YouTube channel and official website. Until next time, this is Zach, the voice guy. If you need a voiceover for your project, I invite you to reach me at the-voice-guy.com. Happy recording and editing, everyone.